Pie charts are great for visually seeing what any item represents of a whole. The problem with pie charts, though, is that it is difficult to show a lot of items. If you have several items that are very small compared to the other items, that may be hard to see on the chart. Also, there is no way of breaking down an item into its components. A pie of pie chart solves these problems by taking a slice of a pie chart and then breaking that slice into another pie chart. This way, you can make those small items visible on a second chart, or you can break down a category into its individual items. In this tutorial, we look at how to create a pie of pie chart, how to view slices as both a percentage and a value, how to change the appearance of an entire pie chart or an individual slice, how to move slices between the charts, how to break down a category of one pie chart into another pie chart, and how to explode an entire pie chart or individual slices. You first need to decide what data you want to include in your pie of pie chart. By default, the last three items in your selected data will appear in the second pie chart. You can change that later by using options to select what items and how many items you want to appear in the second pie chart. I will select the data. I will click on the Insert tab. I will click on the down arrow for the pie chart. I will select the pie of pie chart. I will move the chart and enlarge it. I will click in the chart area. I will click on the Chart Elements button. I will move over the data labels and then click on the arrow to the right of it. As I move through the options, you can see how the labels will appear on the charts. I will select Data Callout. You can see that the last three items of our data appear on the second pie chart. Notice that in the first pie chart, there is a slice named Other that has lines connecting it to the second pie chart. The 17% of Other is represented by the three items on the second pie chart. The first pie chart represents 100%, of which 17% is represented by the second pie chart. I want to include in the data labels the actual amount sold for each item as well as the percentage. I will right-click on one of the charts and then select Format Data Labels. This brings up the pane on the right. I will drag it closer to my chart. I will select Value. If I didn't want percentages as part of data labels, I could remove the check mark from Percentage. While the data labels are selected, I will increase their font size. I will click on the Ribbon's Home tab. If you want to change the position of the labels, you could select one of the label position options. I prefer the outside end. I will right-click on one of the charts, then select Format Series. Currently, the Split Series By is set to Position, and the values in the second plot is set to 3. These are the defaults. I want 4 items to appear in the second pie chart, so I will change the 3 to a 4. Excel moved the next item from the bottom of our selected data to the second chart. I will change the Split Series By to Value. When you select Value, Excel displays a box asking for values less than. I want the items that have a value of less than 6 to appear on the second chart, so I will enter 6 for values less than. I will change the Split Series By back to Percentage Value. I want the four drinks to appear on the right pie chart. Pepsi has a percentage of 12. Since the box asks for less than, I will enter 13. You can move pie slices from one chart to the other by first selecting Custom from Split Series By. You can then select the pie slice you want to move. I will select the Pepsi slice. I want to move it to the first chart, so I will select First Plot from the Point Belongs To combo box. I will press Ctrl plus Z to return the Pepsi slice back to the second chart. The chart shows that the four drinks are part of the other slice. Since we are breaking down our drinks category into types of drinks, the word other is meaningless. I will change the word other to drinks. Right-click on the pie chart, then select Format Data Series. The farther to the right you drag the pie explosion, the more distance there will be between the pie slices. Changing the gap width changes the distance between the two charts. Changing the second plot size changes the size of the second chart. You can even make the second chart larger than the first chart. You can drag out individual pie slices. I will drag out the drinks pie slice to emphasize it. I will convert the pie of pie chart to a bar of pie chart. I will select Change Chart Type. I will select the bar of pie. As with other Excel charts, you can change the layout, color, or style of the chart. I will change the color of the charts by clicking on Change Colors and selecting the third row, which is named Colorful Palette. After you have subscribed to this channel, click on the link in the description below to get great free content. Thank you, and have a great day.